In this video, we're going to discuss how to take a leakage measurement on a load cell using a mega ohm meter. First step would be to isolate the cell or to remove it from the J-box or the indicator. And to do the test, you're going to need a mega ohm meter that can read up into the hundreds of mega ohms. Standard digital voltmeter isn't going to read high enough for this test. You also need to make sure that the meter that you're using doesn't apply more than 50 volts of test voltage. Because if you try to use a tester for insulation resistance that, for example, uses 1,000 volts, you can damage the load cell. There are three tests that we can do. We can check from the individual load cell leads to the shield on the cable, the individual load cell leads to the body of the cell, and from the shield on the cable to the body of the cell. So for the first test, we're going to take all of the leads and tie them together and hook one lead from the mega ohm meter there, and the other lead we're going to hook to the shield connection. Don't touch the two connections while you're doing the test because it can affect the reading. We should get a reading greater than 1,000 meg for a good cell. Second test is to again check from all the leads tied together to the body of the cell, or connect to some piece of the framework that's in direct contact with the cell. And that should also be greater than 1,000 meg. And the final test is to go from the shield on the load cell cable to the body of the cell. And that should also be greater than 1,000 meg.